alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulil karim amma ba'd assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Our third question today, inshallah, for our Shia brothers and sisters is that we see that the Shias, they believe that after the demise of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an who was entitled to the Khilafat and who again and again would request Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an to hand over the Khilafat. And they also believe that it is farz-e-ayn, it is compulsory and it is necessary upon us to accept him as the first Khalifa. Now, we see that if it is compulsory upon us to accept him as the first Khalifa, then it is compulsory upon him to become the first Khalifa and to accept himself as the first Khalifa. At the same time, we see in a book, in a very reliable, a very authentic book, according to the Shias, which is named Nahjul Balagha, we see that the author, in many places in his book, he mentions that Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, he had done isti'fa from the Khilafat. Isti'fa means to resign from the Khilafat. And whilst he was resigning from the Khilafat, the author mentions, it's been mentioned on page 136, on page 322, and at the same time it's been mentioned on page 366, that Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, whilst resigning from the Khilafat, he also said that please leave me alone and choose somebody else for this position apart from me. Now my question to the Shias is that if it was necessary upon Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala to be the next Khalifa after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen him to become the next Khalifa, then why would he resign in such a manner, saying that please choose somebody else apart from me for this position? Why would Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants him to be the Khalifa, pass it over to somebody else? Now, if we begin blaming the Sahaba radiallahu anhum and the other companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for handing over and for choosing somebody else for the Khilafat of Rasulullah after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we begin blaming these people and abusing and swearing at these people for this reason, then this same blame, it can go over to Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, because he himself said that pass it over to someone apart from me. Now this can further be understood through a beautiful example, that we as Muslims have to believe that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a prophet. And then also it is compulsory upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to believe himself as a prophet and to accept the prophethood. We see that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't have a choice whether to be a prophet or not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed him with prophethood, give him the prophethood, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went out there and he passed on the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now if Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if he begins refusing this position that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him, and he passed it over to somebody else, what would we have to say about this? This is exactly what we say about Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, and this is exactly the situation that we put ourselves in with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. Now the fourth question that I'd like to pause is regarding a rumor that is being spread on the internet over the YouTube about Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and that is that when Hazrat Fatima, the beloved daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when she went to Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala to ask for her right of inheritance, some Shia youngsters are going around spreading rumors that Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala at that time had disgraced and denigrated Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala, and at the same time he pushed her, and due to which she broke a rib and she had a miscarriage. Now, for our Shia brothers and sisters to go around spreading such fables, this actually pierces Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu's courage, his dignity and his honor. Why? Because someone who has a slight bit of dignity, somebody who has a slight bit of honor, would never endure seeing his wife being denigrated by another. Regardless of who the person is, regardless of any sort of political power, if anybody sees another person disgracing his wife, especially when it leads to a miscarriage, no man in the right mind would actually accept that and stay quiet. Now, a person, he can say that, okay, due to the political power of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, that's why Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he didn't say anything. Similarly, in Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu's khilafat, we can give the benefit of doubt and we can say that, okay, because of Hazrat Umar's political power, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he didn't say anything. Again, in the time of Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, because of his political power, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu's hands were tied. But then, okay, what about the khilafat of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala? All the political power was in his hands. His hands were totally free, his tongue was totally free to say anything, whatever he wanted about Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, about Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala, about Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. But what do we see? We see Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala in his own khilafat, where he could have said whatever he wanted and nobody could have said anything to him. We see that Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he is standing on the minbar of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he's praising people like Hazrat Abu Bakr, he's praising people like Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. In a hadith, in a narration tradition mentioned by the son of Hazrat Ali, whose name is Muhammad bin Ali, he says that one day my father, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he stood upon the minbar and he called out to the people that, Ya ayyuhan nas, man ashja'un nas, that, O people, who is the most courageous of people? So all the people replying back to him, they said to him that, O Ali, you are the most courageous. So Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he says that, no. He says, I am such a person, if anybody has ever combined with me, I have always taken revenge. But the most courageous and the most brave person is Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And then after this, he goes on to mention that how one day he and some other companions, they were standing whilst some politicians of Makkah, they began beating Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he says that we stood back because we didn't have the courage to go forth. But he says that by coincidence, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, he was passing by, and when he saw that these people are beating Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he threw himself in the midst of these people and he saved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we can see that Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala in his khilafat, when he could have said whatever he wanted about Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and we see him on the minbar praising Hazrat Abu Bakr, praising his courage and bravery and his help that he had given to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At the same time, if we look at this hadith, we see something that Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala has said. He says that if anybody has ever combated me, I have always taken a revenge back. Now this incident that happened between Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and Hazrat Fatima, if this incident really happened and if this incident is true, then this declares Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu as a liar. Because we know that if a person, he combats a wife, he has combated the husband. If he has disgraced the wife, he's disgraced the husband. Now we see that Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he's saying that whoever has ever combated me, I have taken revenge. You can look in the books of hadith, you can look in the books of history, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he has never ever taken revenge from Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala for this incident that these people are going around and spreading. So either I would advise those people that who are going around and spreading such fables, that spreading this sort of stuff regarding Hazrat Ali, Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, either declares him a liar or either declares him a coward. Declares him as a liar because he is saying that if anybody has ever combined against me, I have taken revenge. We see that he never took revenge. Or if it did happen, then it declares him as a coward, because how can a man, a true man, a man who was known for his courage amongst the Arabs, you know, a man who in the Battle of Khandaq is a very famous story about Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, a man who was ready to combat and combine, a person who was very well known to be equal to 1,000 men in war. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the battle of Khandaq, he combated this person and finally he killed the person. Now such a courageous man, how can it be that Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he doesn't go to Hazrat Abu Bakr and he never even mentions anything that due to you, my wife had a miscarriage. So if we do go around spreading these types of fables, it will either declare Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu a coward, or either it will declare him a liar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from going around spreading such rumors about Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the true path, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our hearts with the love of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well as the love of the Ahl Bayt, the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite the Shia brothers and the Sunni brothers so that we can live with each other. Wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.